Hi, my name is Troy Parfit, and I'm the author of a new two-volume book called The Devil and His Due, How Jordan Peterson Plagiarizes Adolf Hitler. And what I want to do is tell you very basically how I discovered Jordan Peterson is plagiarizing the writing and speech of Adolf Hitler, just in the most basic terms, okay? So I first got to know who Jordan Peterson was in about 2017. A friend of mine recommended that I watch him. So I watched one of his videos, and probably within about 2 minutes, I realized that he was a dictator, like a fascistic type, just from his speech, like, I have the answers, I will tell you what the answers are, that's that, that's a fact, it's indisputable, and so on. And so I've watched enough public intellectuals to know that that's not normal for a public intellectual, and so I wondered why he would claim to know the truth and the facts and that only he had them and so on, and why he would exhibit obvious characteristics of a fascistic type. So that made me very, very suspicious. So I learned something about Peterson. So he's a clinical psychologist at the University of, who teaches at the University of Toronto, teaches psychology. Before that, from 1993 to 1998, he taught at Harvard University. And basically, he's got two stated aims. One is he wants to warn people about the reemergence of communism and or Nazism. And also he wants people to get their lives in order and to take personal responsibility and strengthen themselves and so on. However, I couldn't help but notice that these two aims are unrelatable, incompatible, and that he never actually really seemed to be doing these things. So he would slam communism, for example, but he would never talk about he'd never really criticized Nazism. And also his exhortations about exuding strength and taking personal responsibility, he never really sort of fleshed out what he meant by those things. So I thought he's not even adhering his objectives. He's not really even performing his objectives. I don't see any evidence of that. So I became really, really suspicious about who this guy was and what he was after. So after that, I began to gather information about him, and I started listening to his speeches and his classroom lectures and his debates and so on. But I kind of flatlined. I couldn't find any evidence to support my the notion that he was a dictator type. However, what I did notice was that he lied a lot. He lied all the time, is what I eventually figured out. And I got a bunch of notebooks, and I kept notebooks and documented his lies. Of course, that made me suspicious too. What kind of public intellectual would habitually lie? I also became extremely suspicious when he praised a serial rapist and serial murderer named Paul Bernardo, who is a Canadian criminal. He's currently serving life in prison for the rape of 13 girls and the murder of three girls. So he raped and murdered three girls, two of whom I think were 14 and one of whom was 15. Paul Bernardo is one of Canada's most notorious criminals. When the case happened in the 1990s, it was the country was captivated by this because it was such a heinous crime and so on. And according to Peterson, Bernardo was worthy of praise because he was an expert liar. He lied to the police. He pretended not to know anything about this and blamed the police for this, that, and the other thing. And Peterson said that he was amazing, called his performance to the police amazing, said that he was good looking, and said that he's just so good at what he does. And I found this to be just incredibly shocking, and that he would tell his students this at the University of Toronto. So I was extremely suspicious. I thought that he was psychopathic, that he was possibly a white supremacist or maybe a closet Nazi, but I just didn't have enough evidence to put pen to paper. I had a breakthrough when I watched a debate between him, Jordan Peterson, and Sam Harris that was mediated by someone named Douglas Murray in London that was ostensibly about ontology, or what Sam Harris called facts and values. And at the end of what was, I thought, a really boring debate, someone asked, I think it was someone from the audience asked, you know, you've told us about your loves. What is it that you, what is it that you hate? And Peterson said that he hates, or seemingly said, I hate the fact about myself that I know that I could have been, and I quote, deeply satisfied with being an Auschwitz guard, and that he could have performed his duties at Auschwitz with happiness, And he said this twice with searing intensity, happiness, happiness. And I thought, right, okay, that's, yes, that's that's insanity. That, so he's admitting that he wants to, he would have liked to do his bit for Hitler in a war effort or to murder Jews. And incredibly, no one talked about this afterwards. They talked about how he had a very strange conceptualization of truth, and how he linked it to biology and so on. I thought people were really, really missing the point. By this time, I had listened to Peterson speak for hundreds of hours, but this is one of the first times that I'd heard him talk about Hitler. So I Googled Peterson and Hitler, Peterson and Nazis, and I looked at other videos where he's just talking about Hitler or just talking about the Nazis. And I found six or seven videos where he does this. And I didn't know that those videos existed. So I'd heard him mention Hitler here and there, but I didn't know that he was, that he also lectured on Hitler, taught about Hitler. And what I found in the videos was really, really shocking. Far from warning about Nazism, he praised Nazism. He praised Hitler. He said that he was intelligent. He said that he was good at art. He was good at speaking. He was good at reviving the economy. He did some goose stepping in class, and he said this is, he imitated goose stepping in class and said this is an imitation, this is the soldiers imitating the dictator in an absolutely perfect way. He praised Hitler's willpower, gave him gave the Nazi salute. And I thought, wow, that, and it's not for educational reasons. He obviously, he was enamored with Hitler, and it just didn't stop. So I collected maybe, I don't know, 30 examples of him identifying with Hitler, lionizing Hitler, defending Hitler, praising Hitler, and there was hardly any criticism at all. And I thought, that's just amazing. And he also told a story about how Hitler was in a trench and how a mortar landed in the trench and killed all of his friends. But Hitler lived, obviously, in World War I. Peterson said, you know, Hitler must have been thinking, God has saved me for a special purpose or something like that. So I Googled Hitler quotes, and Hitler says something like, who's to say I'm not under God's protection? And I thought, he's plagiarizing Hitler. So what he said about Hitler was actually kind of plagiarism. So in 2018, Peterson spent quite a lot of his time stumping for a book called Hitler's Table Talk. He did this on the Joe Rogan Experience, and he did this when he spoke to Ethan Klein and encouraged people to read Hitler's Table Talk, citing the book as amazing, which was the same word that he used to describe Paul Bernardo's theatrics in front of the Canadian police. It's amazing. And I that made me really suspicious. Why does he use the same word to describe these two things? So I got Hitler's Table Talk. So it's, Hitler's Table Talk is a book where it's sort of rambling, semi-incoherent speeches that were compiled by his staff from 1939 to 1942. And I read it, and I read enough of it to find that Peterson had possibly plagiarized little bits here and there. It wasn't anything really conclusive, but it made me think that he was possibly stealing from Hitler. And I also wondered, why would he advocate this book? Why would he suggest that people read Hitler's Table Talk, which is quite an obscure book? And why wouldn't he say, if he was really trying to warn about Nazism, why wouldn't he encourage people to read Mein Kampf, so that people could see how fascism comes about, if he was really warning about Nazism, if he was really warning about fascism, which by this point I already knew that he wasn't, given all the praise and so on that I'd seen him give to Hitler. So I finally bought Mein Kampf and read it, wondering if Peterson was perhaps inspired by Mein Kampf. What I wasn't expecting to find was that he wasn't only inspired by my Mein Kampf, but that he was plagiarizing the book. And it only took me 2 hours to realize that he had systematically plagiarized this book. And Hitler's favorite words like strength, power, aim, transform, manifest, and so on were Peterson's favorite words. And initially, I compiled several instances of plagiarism between Hitler's spoken text and Mein Kampf. And then so the next step was to get 12 Rules for Life. And that's when everything broke wide open. When I got Peterson's best-selling book published by Penguin, 12 Rules for Life, An Antidote to Chaos, I realized that that book had been systematically plagiarized from Mein Kampf. And I found hundreds of examples of plagiarism, hundreds. And so I documented them all. And then once I was done with Mein Kampf, I got Hitler's Zweites book, which is his second book, which is a book that was shelved. It's a manuscript that was written in 1928. It's about 200 pages. And I realized that he'd also plundered that book. And then I got Hitler's speeches, which all of his speeches from 1922 to 1945, and realized that he'd pilfered from Hitler's speeches. And I took a closer look at Hitler's table talk and found not many examples of plagiarism from Hitler's table talk, but maybe 8 or 10 or something like that, a handful. So so eventually I compiled, I don't know how many, but it's well over 1,000, possibly 2,000, I haven't counted, instances of plagiarism where Jordan Peterson systemically plagiarizes the writings and the speech of Adolf Hitler. So there you go. I haven't given you any of the examples, but that's not the point of today's talk. I'm just telling you how I discovered that Jordan Peterson has plagiarized Adolf Hitler. Again, my name is Troy Parfit, and I'm the author of a book called The Devil and His Due, How Jordan Peterson Plagiarizes Adolf Hitler. Thank you for listening.